Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Super Mario 64. In the last episode, whenever we were in the metal area getting the metal cap, he was correct halfway on the enemy name. It is Sniffit in Japan, but in America, it was called a Snuffit, I believe is what it was.
Yeah. I know some of the names, dude. I just don't understand why we change names around. Call it what it was called. Like I said, I'll still alliterate. I don't know why we changed Peach's name to Princess Toadstool for a while, but we did.
But yes, he was halfway correct, because that is the name of the character in Japan's version of Mario 64.
And we're going to pick up where we left off, going to World 2 is our first destination.
Why I will say, this is probably my favorite world.
It's all right. It feels rather small. I wish it was kind of a little bigger, but, you know, the warp kind of takes away that factor.
The warp just kind of like, you want to beat this level in 2 seconds? Okay, cool, go here.
I just have a one-up chill right behind me.
You should do the Green Demon Challenge.
I'm fine. I am not attempting that challenge. I'm just gonna not stomp him, but phase through him, of course. I just love that little glitch. Phase right through the Womp King. It's my ground pounding. 3DS, they did change that. You can't do it. They patched it out.
I like how they redid this level and, first Mario Galaxy, or was it the second one?
Second one, I believe. I think it's called Throwback Galaxy.
Yeah.
Towards the very end of the game, too. That's kind of weird.
It was a pretty unique level how they did that. How they brought the old music back and kind of redid the level, but it's awkward camera angles and Mario flying around the map all the time.
Yeah, well, shit, didn't even hit that side.
Just run into the sign, why don't you?
Yeah, it's Galaxy 2 because you have Cloud Mario.
Yeah.
Because I just realized it's Cloud Mario because you're going to run and get silver stars.
Run away from the Green Demon.
Mario likes one-ups, though. Keeps him alive.
I mean, they do, but you hardly ever die in this game, so.
Not really. I either die to just being freaking clumsy, Mario not grabbing the right ledge. It's just usually the last third of the game or Bowser's worlds I die in. Sometimes I'll just burn my butt to death.
I will say, I really like this game. I used to play it a lot as a kid. I'm sure a lot of people did whenever they were.
Yeah, screw the game.
Younger. Are you just gonna do the wall jump? Yeah, I figured you would. It's the easiest way to get up there.
Save the cannon for the 6-star. There you go. I barely use that cannon for this star. Unless I need the coins up there. Which this stage is littered with blue coins. So, man, you don't need to really go far out for looking.
Yeah, it's like, what, almost over 60?
Almost 150.
Oh, wow, really? That many blue coins?
It's a lot of blue coins.
That's a lot of blue coins. You could get the coin star alone just with that. Okay, Mr. Owl, take us away.
The best thing you want to do when grabbing the owl is be still, because literally, whatever momentum you had when you touched him carries the instant he drops you.
Yep.
To be honest, I just find it easier just to go. See, since I jump straight up, I go straight down. It's just easier to get
and
up here.
You smack your face on the platform.
It's so much easier than climbing.
Yeah, yeah. Honk.
That's fine.
Get those coins.
Phase right through them.
That, I guess you could say, the little glitch.
It works. I'll take it. I'm already at 30, I'm not even trying. Yes. That's a one-up I usually miss too. But I got it.
You just about jumped off the edge there.
It wouldn't be the first time.
I've done it before too, so don't worry.
Open this up for the 6-star. I have not learned how to wall clip into it.
Oh, come on.
I don't know how to. I can't get it right. The angle, I just keep messing it up.
I've seen so many speedrunners do that, but they say it's like so hard because you have to be so perfect at it.
I keep practicing at it. I just still have trouble with it. So I just shoot and run up and get it. I do kind of like the music in this.
I will say this is probably one of the more iconic songs of Mario. That, well.
I do hate when that happens. I do hate when that happens. Their hitbox are kind of rounded out. You gotta hit it just right.
This song and the Dire Dire Docks song, I'm gonna go ahead and say is
love Dire Dire Docks.
Iconic songs from this franchise.
We'll leave that plant alone.
Aw, I'm trying.
You son of a bitch. You respawn freaking fast.
Isn't it every time you kill one of those guys you get a blue coin, or is it just once?
Every time.
That's crazy. That's just crazy.
Just need one more coin.
Last red coin.
See, there's still a bunch of coins littered around, but I just don't pick them up.
Oh, yeah. And last red coin.
Double star.
Coin star. And you're going to get pushed off the edge. Or maybe not.
Nope. I've actually had Mario almost glitch through the floor like that.
I can only imagine.
But I jumped and it recorrected them out.
I will say, I think my funniest moment that I've ever had was actually here when we were practicing our BLJs, and I BLJ'd right into Wet Dry World.
Oh, crap, I had some momentum on that. Have to be careful. Yeah, I'll never understand that. I still think it's weird.
I don't even know how I did it. I was trying to backwards long jump up the freaking steps to
last area of the game.
The last area of the game, and for some magical reason, I backwards long jumped through the ground and right into Wet Dry World.
Yeah, more of a wrong warp. It was quite hilarious. Right into the top of the painting too.
Yeah, awkward wrong warp. I don't even know why you'd use that.
I didn't know it was a thing.
I didn't either.
Boom. Well, hell, I'll take one hit. Usually I lose like half my health doing that shit. We're about to literally already complete this fortress. Yeah, come
on. They make the weirdest sounds when they die. Whoa. The bout fell off and you just got chomped to death.
I've tried to run over that plank so many times and I've ran off more than I want to count.
Physics, because standing on a wall that's slanted makes you stand.
It's Mario. He's got glue on his feet.
Unlike his brother who has slipper shoes.
No, they're called butter shoes.
Butter shoes. Good old butter shoes, Luigi.
Now to a nice, calm music piece.
Yeah. I guess you could say one of the most iconic songs from the game, Jolly Roger Bay.
Yeah. I mean, I just love water levels for the fact their tunes either super catchy or just memorizingly relaxing.
Right.
But this world, we get to play with a big-ass evil. That you see right there.
Unless they're like Zelda water levels.
They're difficult to construct eggs.
They
need to learn from Mario. I know there's a way to clip into this, but I've still yet to master that one. I think I've got it only once.
That's probably my most hated.
And unlucky. Oh, oh. This big platforming section, I hate it. It's so slippery, but you know, just swim up here and you made it.
You know, as a kid, I never realized I could do that. I always waited till the water drained all the way down, and then I had to climb all the way up here.
Same.
Ever.
I've done. I was the same way. Till I was like, man, this water's draining slow. I could have just swam up there.
I know, right?
But I don't know how to swim ground pound to get the star. Here comes a star that might give me trouble, depending on how the eel plays.
Oh, the tail star for the eel?
Yep. Yeah. I've gotten in the first shot. I've had to get 3 laps out of that thing to get it. Depends on how I can react fast enough. Yeah, I don't run into the damn eel.
He does do a good amount of damage.
This is what I want. See? If you can get a situation like this, you can easily tell when that star is about to come out.
You can see it through the wall, and then you can swim right down and grab it like it's nothing.
Yep. Just gotta not hit his tail, and boom. That's how you get it. Easy peasy.
Get it the easy way.
Heck yeah. That could be quite annoying, because if you hit the eel, you are most likely going to die.
Right.
That's 3 units of health. Man, he hurts.
Let's go.
Treasure? Man, we're going to be pirates now. And now that we got this eel star, we probably pissed him off. Now he's not going to hide anymore. Now he's just swimming around. There are random Goombas in this cave. I never understood. They just threw random Goombas.
Ka-chunk.
Oops, forgot that's the last one. I'll never remember that either. I always get those mixed up.
It's back, left, right, front.
Yeah, yeah.
It's always the same pattern.
And speedrun strat. There you go. But if you have the metal cap, that shock won't hurt you at all.
I think it just stuns you, doesn't it?
Yeah, it stuns you in place. You just don't take the damage. Right. All right, 100 coin mission again. Woo-hoo. And there's actually limited coins, so you're going to have to seek them all out.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I know. Yippee. I think there's just barely over 100 coins. I want to say 103 coins?
Yeah.
Just barely over 100. I mean, they really want you to seek them all out in this stage. It's the only thing I discredit about the water stages. Man, they skimp on those coins. I think I missed a coin. Yep, hey, I was right. Missed one.
Good job.
Give me a coin. What the hell was that? Open up and say, ah.
Ah.
You're not a clam.
No, but you said open up and say, ah, so I did.
I was talking to the clam. Open you up for star 5. There is a way, it's more of a speed run that you can shoot at the wall and angle it where it actually will just propel you to the platform.
Right.
Man, it is a specific spot. And I used to be able to do it. I didn't do it for a while and forgot where that spot was.
I always love that little flip it does off any high post like that. It's super cool.
Just collecting these right now. I know. Well, I said there's a little over 100.
Ka-chunk.
How many do I have? 4. Okay, good. I'm on my way. There's three on the ship. Five.
Coin ring.
Yep, line the center and you get a one up. Okay, this game plays nice now when we're recording. Man, I never get those one ups. I like that. Fuckers keep going around. Was that an invisible pillar that just hit me?
Good job, and you missed the blue.
I did not even see the pillar hit Mario.
There's all your blue coins.
Get
all three of them.
Tried. Too bad they don't give you extra coins for stomping them in a row.
I know, right?
There's the metal cap you ever wanted. I think they want you to get it for the chest so you just don't shock the shit out of yourself.
Right.
Almost
done. Although I don't think they expect you to have it at this point yet.
If going in order, no.
Right.
Because there is, I probably said there isn't a star until World 6. There is one right there in front of me, but if you're a good swimmer...
Yeah, you can just swim right to that one.
You don't even need a metal cap. You can just swim to it. The angle's a little weird, so you gotta be careful. There's 104 coins. I was one off. I missed 4 coins up there. I just wish we had Mario logic. You hurt? Go swimming. Now you feel better.
That makes a whole lot of sense, doesn't it?
Oh! I didn't press the A button in time. I ran right off the edge. I ain't gonna blame the controller. That was me. Try again.
One.
You know, I always found this jump hard as a kid to get up here.
I know, right?
Until I realized you can just backflip up there, really. If you time it right.
And there's Yellow Star.
I was satisfied to get 2-1.
One. Here we go! You have to save.
I know, right? It's like, you want to go back to course select screen? Yeah. Let me stay in this world. You know, one thing I always pondered as a kid, where does Mario keep all his coins?
I know, right? He picks them up. What does he have, like a piggy bank or something that he puts them all in? Or does he, like...
Mini pocket dimension where he stores...
Mini pocket dimension, yeah.
And who puts all these coins there?
That's another question. What does each go through every level and just... Good shot. I didn't think you were going
to
get that.
I thought I missed it. Now I'll take damage to get that first try.
Bonk.
Normally, I undershoot that a lot. Here we go! There's only a certain portion of the pillar you can grab.
Right.
Either I undershoot it horribly or I overshoot it and go just straight over the damn ship to you. Alright, hopefully I get this first try.
Through the jet stream.
This is where you want your metal cap, but like I said, if you just swim fast enough, it's you don't need it.
I think you can get it with the turtle shell.
No, the turtle shell wears out by the time you get there, before you get there. There's the turtle shell. Grab it for just a few seconds.
It does wear out before you get there. That's weird. Can you get it without getting the metal cap?
I didn't have enough speed built up. That turtle shell that wore out way long. It should be longer than I expected. It shouldn't be that big a deal. I ain't gonna die trying.
Yeah, just get another hot start run of it.
You just gotta have fast speed while swimming and it makes it easier.
Go, 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 go. You're right there. Come on, get it, Mario.
There it is.
Go.
Here we go. You just barely get it.
All right.
So Mario's gonna dry off and we're gonna go with some more code.
Oh boy.
It might be three worlds in one setting here.
Oh, these worlds are going fast now.
It's the first tier worlds. They're short.
Right.
Course 5, Big Boo's Mansion is where it starts to get its length.
I'm ready for good old Hazy Maze.
I don't really enjoy that area. That damn hole in that one middle area. I don't like it. I've died way too many times in that hole.
Yeah. you missed.
Especially going for 100 coins. You get almost 100 coins, and it sucks when you get killed.
So, I don't think I ever got 100 coins on this one. Unless it's all the kid.
Yep. Well, it's a secret right here. Nice little secret to take. Two extra lives. That last one is a bitch life to get, so that's fine. I think there is almost 80 something coins on that slice, so you can rack up coins. Which makes a 100 coin mission in this game, this world, so easy.
I do hate that you can't cheat. Here we go!
Aw, come on, it's called cheating. You take a secret path.
The game's like, no. You don't get to do this, you're cheating.
Oh, well, on Kaizo, there's actually a star at the, end, the beginning of that, but it's blocked off from the slide. Kaizo Mario 64 is a bitch. I've seen the whole thing, all of it, and I was like, man, that'd take me forever to get some of that shit.
Alright, Penguin Race time.
It would be, but sadly, I actually just forgot what course star I was on, honestly.
Uh-oh.
I meant to get the baby penguin.
Ah.
I autopiloted so bad there. We're actually going for a lost penguin.
Not going for the race, we're going for the penguin.
Well, it had penguin in its name, so I just don't like doing this mission. Penguin won't shut up.
I don't think anybody likes doing this mission because the penguin is too loud.
Well, that works. Anyway.
And score.
It's short, but I just don't like the penguin cry.
Yeah, the penguin cry is pretty annoying.
There we go. There's our next star.
As long as you pick it up again, you can have her, yeah, push you into the star. Really? Come on, bro.
I'm gonna do it. I did it.
Aww.
I killed the penguin.
Mario's a
killer now. Like he has to kill Koopas and Goombas. Do not admit that you did not want to do that too when you were younger.
I don't ever kill the penguin. I just put the penguin down and then get the star.
You don't enjoy fun, do you? Yeah, so many people do that just because they don't like the penguin. Now we get to properly erase this guy.
And go. I always thought that the mission that I hated the most was the snowman one.
Oh, you gotta be careful. He has bumped me off many times on these corners. Sucks when he cheats.
He can cheat, but you can't.
I know, right?
Good. 78 coins already.
I have walked out that door by accident. I have seen other people do it too. It's so easy to do when going for the star. That's why they put it so low, you walk right into it. Dirty stars. Now we can access Bowser's second area.
All right.
If we so choose. But that's way down the road.
We haven't even beaten the first area fully yet.
No, we're still in the first tier stages.
All right. Let's get some 8 red coins.
Yep. That's right. Over here. Red coin over here.
I always wonder what the point of that giant ice pillar was.
Why? Just to be a douche. Alright,
yeah, you and your little shortcut. And into the snow you go.
That's fine. Snow physics. I've ran off that edge before. And you're always wondering, it's like, how do I get back up? Right there. That's how you get back up to the top. Now we're going down some slide for coins.
So, I got a question for you guys down there in the comments. What other N64 games would you like to see from us? Maybe some Banjo-Kazooie or Tooie, or maybe some Star Fox, or maybe some of the other 64 games.
Fuck, I miss those boys.
Just leave your comments below and let us know what else we should play.
Also, let us know if you've ever done the penguin kill yourself.
Some of the coins in that slide is ridiculous.
Oh yeah, it's a
like
lot of
coins. Like
they
just said, here you go. We're gonna put all the slides. We're gonna put all the slides in the coins. Wow, good job.
Yeah,
we're gonna put all the coins in the slide.
If there's a slide, there's a big chance there's a lot of coins attached to it.
I like the,
we will not ever talk to him, because I make that cannon useless.
Oh, what slide is it? The mountaintop slide.
Yeah, that's back in Tall Tall Mountain.
Tall Tall Mountain slide, yeah, I like that one. It's because the background looks so weird when you're going down the slide.
It looks weird, but it's pretty cool.
Whee! What is that all about?
Coming down here because I missed the red coin.
Ah.
Grab this. Six.
I'd have laughed if I jumped up and got that star.
I would have been angry at myself and sad at the same time. Come up here, we just got two more red coins and six coins to grab. I meant to punch it, not jump on it. That's a one-up. I don't really need it.
Also, down in the comments, what games did you guys play as kids? Like, what was your first console that you guys played? Mine, of course, was the Nintendo 64.
Mine was NES. I was in the NES era. Proud of it. My mother was actually good at some games I couldn't beat her in. Iframes!
Yeah, anytime I'm playing this game, my grandmother is always like, oh, that's Mario 64, I used to play that game all the time. Here we go! I'm like, wow, I didn't know that my grandmother used to actually play video games.
Yeah, you'd be surprised who plays games these days or used to. It's like NES was accessible for anybody.
Right.
Here we go!
Like, my mother, kind of like Dr. Mario, Tetris, Yoshi's Cookie, man, she would school my ass on it. It took me years to be able to come over that and beat her. But she would always keep playing those kind of games and try to get better. Like Tetris, she was,
I've seen you play Tetris and you're really good at that game.
Yeah, now it took me years and years of practice, but man, for the longest time I never could be better than her at Tetris. Another game she can beat me in, it's not a video game, but Sudoku. She can clear those puzzles, man. I can wrap my brain on it. She can stare at a hard puzzle like it's an easy puzzle.
You know, every time I did this one, I always thought that you had to punch the snowman. Like,
nope.
You had to punch the ball or stand there and let it hit you.
Nah, it's weird, but I've always thought a ball, like, my thing was, I thought you had to be in front of it to go.
Right.
But the trick is, as long as you don't, I guess you can actually go far, but as long as you're on the other side of the snowman, it follows where you're at.
Okay.
But we're going to grab this star real quick before we're wrapping up. And this is why I said I'm going to make that kind of useless.
Is this the last star for this world?
Yes, it is.
All right. So this will be three worlds in one episode. Well, that's crazy.
Jump on this guy.
Yeah, yeah. You and your little spinny man jump.
Jump on the spin man, and you literally can just
float all the way down. straight to the star.
Oh. Well, if I didn't bump my head, I would have, literally.
There you go.
It's because I bumped my head, I could not do it. But I usually do. I usually float and just get to the star. And a cannon is made useless.
Alright, everybody. Well, that's going to be it for this episode of Super Mario 64. Thanks for tuning in.
We're going to have more coming down the road.